CD.
Today is the first day the group get a chance to relax. And after driving up over 11,000 feet and across 500 kilometres, no one can blame them. Peter and Conti are feeling a little bit more proactive, so drive into the desert for some playtime with the cars that no one is using.
This is Padam, 8 feet off the ground. He thought that this car is a plane.
We reached there and Vivek asked a crucial question. Can we really push the cars hard? He candidly told Vivek, if you push the car, whatever the you want to do, do what you want, as long as you go into the snow and shovel it out on your own, lose that much driving time. Okay, no problem. Anyway, so this was planned out. He says, I'm coming. He comes around, window down, minus 42 degrees. He's coming in, sharp curve. The car goes. He's not shoveling the snow under the car. He's shoveling the glow from within the car. Because the window was open, all the snow came in.
The whole school shut down for that 20 minutes.
To come and see.
Everybody came there with their cameras to say that this is the first time they would have put up on the hall.
Hall of Fame.
They took 6 hours to take the car out.
Yeah.
So, this is what happens. There's a slight lapse of concentration on my part.
Hi, can you explain what happened?
Basically, just sent the car for a little servicing. It's up on a ramp right now, so that they clean the underside.
We just also wanted to have the locals have a look at the underbody, because there's quite a lot of technique which they should see.
Technology,
yeah.
Literally at 1 or 2 miles an hour, over a step just slightly too big because I was 3 feet to the right, or I should have been 3 feet further to the left.
Everything is drilled out. He's like 20 minutes away from here. He has no radio connection, so we're fine. Let's take some time.
So the locals are helping me dig the car out. Not sure what the damage is at the moment, but Conti and Harry are on their way with the tow truck to the rescue.
But before we help them, let's have lunch first.
A realization of who owns that particular Audi is made.
Yeah, but you bought a second-hand Mercedes. Obviously, they've taken stuff off it. It's so light that it flew, yeah?
With all due respect, he said you ordered it for him.
It would seem everyone is feeling a bit embarrassed at the moment. Well, almost everyone.
An Audi got stuck in the sand. How sad is that?
We know.
And the Mercedes is going to do the recovery.
And the news in the Bombay newspaper is that the Mercedes is going to do the recovery. How amazing is that today?
That's funny.
Right, thank you to this man who dug the car out. Came out a piece of cake. No problem at all after about half an hour of digging. So, thank you, my friend. What was your name?
Ali Hassan.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Yes. Alright, guys, we're off to the Hemismar Monastery, which is a monastery about 45 kilometers away from Leh, which should be a great visit. All the cars are in convoy. We are going there and we're going to come back to a lovely sunset point in Leh. The sunsets here in this part of the world are absolutely spectacular, as we saw coming in with the shadow coming off the mountains. So that's the plan for now, and then towards the evening we're all going to go and have a nice meal at Bon Appetit. So it's a relatively lighter day today, but moving forward tomorrow we're going to go to Pangyong, which is a really beautiful lake, partly in India and partly in China. So yeah, looking forward to a good day.
The monastery is about 40 kilometres away, situated in the mountains across the river. But before we get there, Gautam spots something.
keep the aria out of it, but I think it'll be nice because I'm sure everybody would like to do a little sand run. That was an interesting day.
Just had the cars cleaned. I don't want to see them after this session of off-roading. Don't want to see them. Kiki Soso Largelo.
And why would you say, what's its significance?
I mean, it's just
a good luck thing.
Good luck, respect, you know, that you're, you know, humble. They say in this area, there's a saying also saying that don't be a gama in the land of the lama. I mean, don't be a fool. Don't do things stupid because, you know, you're really, in a way, in an area where you can't take, don't put it, put your life to risk.
Shall we go out this way? Whoop up, a big one. Whoop up! And down.
But the boys will be boys, and they'll playing with their toys. What to do? Having fun.
Playtime over, we turn back onto the road. We are only a few minutes drive away from the monastery. But as we are climbing, the desert claims its first victim of the rough and tumble. This monastery is the largest of its kind in Ladakh, and it's a rare opportunity for some of the more spiritual members of the group to experience anything like this.
I'm feeling excited, too excited. Mr. Gautam, Mr. Singhania, a lot of the team people have brought me here. It's an exciting journey.
Oh, we're feeling brilliant. We had this Themis monastery, which is supposed to be very nice. And I think the drive up here was brilliant. Not to forget of all the off-roading we did on the way up.
We do some of the chanting of Namyoho Renge Kyo back at home, so it's quite amazing to be here and be able to chant and roll all these wheels. And
it's very powerful.
It's amazing. It's amazing. It's very touching, actually.
And what better backdrop, huh?
Absolutely outstanding. It's mesmerizing.
My name is Topdan, and I usually do guide here, you know. So now I'll just brief about this monastery. This monastery was built in 17th century. There are four sects in Tibetan Buddhism. Mostly you can see two sects in Ladakh. And it was built in 17th century. And the head of this Gonpa is the owner of the three idiot school. You've seen my humor, almost seen that.
Prayer or like hole, and there are like 300 monks live here. During the festival, they all dress up a mask here, and they go out and just for like mask dance to show the people, you know. So
thank you.
I think it's fantastic. The monasteries are something which are really lovely and peaceful, and I mean, part of the driving we did, but it's great to come and see places like this. It's just fantastic. It's a lot of history, and what it's just so serene about it. You feel relaxed. And it's amazing how they built this monastery in the middle of nowhere. It's well off the, maybe 5 or 6 kilometers off the main road. And the drive up was so peaceful. It's absolutely superb.
Everyone leaves the monastery feeling calm and relaxed. By the time we leave, the sun is already about to set, so we miss our sunset today. But that certainly doesn't mean we're short of a view on the way back.
Obviously, the reason why we are heading back and not attending the sunset point is because the sun's gone. We took too long. We took too long at the monastery. We were all very excited. There were individuals like Carl, who's a scholar, so he went to the museum and refused to come out. So in the interest of everybody and everybody's interest and welfare, that we decided not to go there. And we were planning on going there on Friday when we are back from Pangyong Lake.
The way I saw it, it had something to do with the off-roading. The little excursion we went on, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's okay. I'll take the rap for it. We're all good.
After a long and exciting day, the group unwinds at a local restaurant.
Where the hell are you? Come here!
I'm all yours, Prabhu!
Is this more playtime, perhaps? Everyone is excited because today is the day they travel to Pangyong Lake. The route ascends almost 3,000 more feet, a move which makes only one person here nervous.
Very, very excited, I would like to say, very much.
Are you nervous that someone's going to get sick or hurt themselves because they're being sick?
For today, I am very nervous because we are gaining height. We are gaining nearly 3,000 feet, and today we are at 11,000 feet, and we are going to 14,000. So I kindly advise, do not stop. Just keep on going, keep on going, keep on going. Let's reach the destination, and then we will enjoy.
But otherwise, positive.
Otherwise, positive. Hopefully.
The convoy is almost ready to leave, but Gautam is worried about something.
No!
No!
No! You cannot connect an iPad into the Q5.
In the Q5, you cannot, but you can connect it to any other vehicle we have here.
What do we do for music in that car?
You can have an SD card, you can have a USB.
Anybody have an SD card?
Poor Conti.
Vigon! Get in, get in!
Trigun is standing, he's waiting for the cars to go, then he'll follow through.
Do wear your seatbelts for a safe drive.
So here we go, it's 10:10 right now. We are about an hour late because we had, I don't know where it was, we misplaced two keys, let's put it that way. So finally we found them and we are on a journey. We are very excited going to Pangyong Lake right now. I think the journey so far has been brilliant, but this is going to be, I think, awesome.
The convoy needs to drive 15 kilometers out of town and then drive northeast from Karu towards Changla Pass. It's a connecting road at the top of this mountain, but it's really, really high.
What's up? Day number 4 of the Supercar Club Leh Ladakh expedition. Lovely morning. Of course, we're running an hour late, but that's okay. It still has happened. Well, can't believe after 4 months of preparing for this whole thing, we're finally at it. And today's going to be a lovely drive to Pangyong.
Water is very important. On my curve, check your nerve. If married, divorce, speed. Guys, just a reminder, please take a lot of liquids. I mean water and stuff, not alcohol.
Harry knows what he's talking about. His expertise tells him we all need to behave. One false move here is certain death. As the group ascend, the mood changes dramatically. The mountains are a dangerous place. The higher we climb, the higher the risk. And in one piece, we all arrive. But the climb is taking its toll.
Barely breathe, man.
I'm so short of breath, it's ridiculous.
It's like moonwalking, 10 steps and I'm gone. I need a oxygen supply, so I'm gonna light up. Oxygen! Oxygen!
The rapid ascent is enough to bring me to the point of collapse. My chest feels tight and every breath I take is a struggle. There's a very good reason why there are medics up here.
Put your back against that thing. Okay, just breathe normally, you take care of
it. Just take on the right U-turn.
Okay, another left U-turn and you should be here. Mark is not feeling well, he's in the Army Medical Center here. So as soon as you come, just near the main pass area, just stop there.
Feeling like suffocation.
No problem, sir, oxygen.
This is what happens, and I think the Indian Army is doing a great job here to, you know, attend to tourists, which is not there, and, you know, Not part of their job as such, but they're doing a great job here.
Yeah, I mean, hats off to the Indian. And they feel, you know, they give you free tea, no matter what, free of cost, so that's great.
Up at this altitude, you really struggle to breathe, and that's what, you know, Mark has had a little bit of oxygen for 5-10 minutes. His saturated oxygen levels will be back to normal. And he just has to take it easy till we drop down from this altitude. The only answer is to take you down to a lower altitude. That's altitude mountain sickness.
It isn't just someone's condition that can change in an instant here. On the drive back, the group encounter a pocket of cold air, and sun turns to snow.
Hey, hi, we've just done a little bit of off-roading. All went well, all the drivers did a good job. And right now, as you see, we're getting some snowflakes falling down, which is really nice. It makes it more part of the adventure. So we're just quickly rooming our jackets out so we can be nice and warm.
Is in your pocket.
This is the best lunch venue in the world.
I hope you guys have your car keys in your pocket.
16,500 feet. The best gourmet meal in the world. Not a bad idea.
So let's see what we got for lunch. We have an apple. And a boiled egg, some drink, and some choco pie, which is highly pressurized because of the atmosphere.
As the group are eating their lunch, producer Pete gets some good news.
Well, Mark is good now. He has a tiny tingling sensation in his feet, but I think he's ready to do his job.
Hello, Peter.
Hello, mate. You all right?
Yeah, I'm much better now. The docs gave me some oxygen and some IV fluids. Looks like I guess I couldn't ascend as fast as I'd probably hoped.
Lunchtime has turned into playtime, and I want to prove to everyone that my competence hasn't been affected by the run-in with the doctors.
Oh, man!
Man, you're an idiot.
I'm an idiot?
Yeah.
I didn't realize you were doing 100,000 miles an hour.
Break it down.
Well, it's going to go on the donut now. I don't think so. It's a good idea to take this car all the way. So at the next village or wherever
safely, close the door, please?
I think we
please
should park this car
the door,
here and tend to it on our way back.
I agree, there's no other choice.
If we find a puncture, some repair shop somewhere here, we can look into that. Otherwise, we abandon this car here and pick it up on the way back.
Okay.
What's the altitude here?
I don't know, my watch is showing 15,900.
So we're changing a tyre at 15,900.
Having successfully crossed the pass, it's only a matter of a few kilometres between us and Pangyong Lake. This lake is very popular amongst Indians. It's been recently featured in a very popular film, and it's a tourist hotspot, so there's no shortage of overnight rest stops for us to use.
Awesome. What a lovely place.
Somebody has a towel?
Baba, you're pulling your undies up here.
I can't feel my balls anymore, man. I don't think they're there, actually. Well, the plan now is we're going back to our tented hotel. We're gonna wash up, have some tea, freshen up, and then meet for drinks and dinner.
What do you think of the place? You must be over the moon.
It's fantastic. The lake is absolutely beautiful. And now the sun's going down and everybody's going to freeze.
It's got to get colder. We're hoping the wind chill would stay down. But the wind chill goes up, we're looking at getting into like something like -1 or 1 degree or something like that. So keep yourselves warm and try to avoid drinking and smoking, which I do. But yeah, drink something warm.
From one extreme to another, right?
Yeah, it's good. From 37 degrees to probably 7 or 5. I don't know what it's going to be.
Hey man, this is a supercar club.
Yeah.
We're superheroes.
There are few things people can claim to never have done before in this part of the world. But Peter thinks he's found one.
You're mad.
You're doing, dude. You're flying a kite in the Himalayas, man.
Yeah. Well, I'm now out of breath.
Yeah. I hope he's not into China soon.
I don't think he's got a Chinese visa.
Yeah.
I brought my power kite, or one of my small ones, all the way to the Himalayas, and I'm bloody well going to fly it. Hang on, no, don't do that, because it will take off.
PE lesson over, it's time to wrap up warm and go to bed. We are told a visit to Pangyong Lake isn't complete without a sunrise. The sun does rise, but somewhere in China and behind a rain cloud.
We've just slept for about 4 hours, 5 hours each. So this is fun. I mean, when we've come all this way, how often are we going to ever do this again?
Good morning. Cold, raining, and hoping for the clouds to move away so we can see the sun rise. But listen, let's wake everybody up. Let's
look
make sure.
At this, look at this.
Let's make sure everyone's up, and then we'll go back to sleep.
Well, you know what? This is nature, you know. Great. I mean, just look at even at this weather like this. See, the water is absolutely green. You can still see the colors and stuff. And no matter what, even if we don't get to see the sunrise, I'm sure the colors that you'll see are going to be absolutely different.
The rain is short-lived, and the convoy roll out of camp and head back towards Leh. We stop one last time for a photo, and then press on.
It's a f***ing bad road.
Yaks, the backup vehicles for the supercar club.
Hold it.
Watch your chance, watch your chance. It goes for you.
Yeah, you did.
Don't know.
Not really as fast, admittedly, and I'm not really convinced a yak will pass an emissions test.
Oh, I'm good.
Oh, it was excellent, man. Superb. But my friends were so bad, they were paying three times the charges to make me fall down.
Constantine, the Audi rep, is trying out his own second choice, and something tells us he isn't very impressed.
I'm flat out. I was flat through the corner. What does it say? ESP off? Or what does it say? ESP off?
Off. How are you feeling?
The air is really thin, so I'm trying to hyperventilate so that more oxygen gets into my system. What's up, Consti?
Peace, bro.
On our journey back, we have to climb over Changla Pass again. But by now, we're all acclimatized, so no visit to the doctors this time.
Oh, shucks.
There is one more puncture just before the group stop for lunch. It's also obvious that after all the sitting around acclimatizing, the group have some excess energy. Luckily, we know just the place to expel it.
Having a great time, absolutely. We've had five good days. I think one more to go. Luckily, everybody's been good. And I think the boys have had a great time with, drifting, with driving some off-road, going up, the passes and going to Pangyong. And, God is kind. We've mixed as a group well, and I think everybody's having a good time.
Baba! Baba!
What the f*** are you doing? You're flying the car. You don't know what to do. You're already, what the hell is this? And you're, all this is stopped because of you, Bhankichut. You find the Bhankichut ground.
No, pipe to touch.
Chota sa pipe.
Atma pehle niklo to
phir wo gaadi aayegi. Usko English mein radiator kehte hain.
With two cars down and other technical problems in the others brought on by rough terrain, the feeling on the end of this day for some is tiredness and frustration. The hope is that tomorrow's climb, if successful, will mark a happy end to the trip. Preparations are underway. The cars are about to travel to the highest motorable road in the world and need to be ready for it.
It's amazing. It's great to see that we're going up to the highest motorable road in the world. The drive's beautiful, not as difficult as people make it out to be. Let's hope the thin air here doesn't knock us out. The cars are responding beautifully. It's an amazing drive.
Like heaven over here. We got a bulldozer which is clearing a landslide. Yeah, so we're halfway up the Khardungla Pass and it's just started snowing. We're just about making it. We got a massive drop there and there's snow. What more do you want? I mean, everybody's missing out except for us.
It's my first snowflakes.
Oh, you've seen snow before?
I've never been in snow before. It's fantastic. So we're what, about 16,000 feet up? About 16,000 mark? It's good stuff.
Four cars, we already
sold
4 cars.
Look at that.
That's what
you're marketing. Yep, proper snow.
It's one thing about snow, Carl, it doesn't last.
Yeah. I'm glad we came here, you know.
cars here like I'm doing.
Welcome to Khardungla, the highest motorable road in the world. I'm glad with all the preparations and everything, we finally made it up here. And on the way we saw a lovely sight. We saw an aircraft flying below us and we were driving above it. And we're so excited and that we're finally up here. And it's going to be an experience once in a lifetime. I don't think any of us will be up here.
We are pleased to find we are not the only explorers up here.
So we are coming from Delhi by bike. And we stay here during 2 weeks. And now we are going to a round to return to Delhi. And last year we were in Rajasthan. So it was a pleasure to return and to come back in India.
As the French bikers leave, Harry spots another kind of French biker. Though this one is perhaps a little bit more impressive.
Yay!
No. What I want to do is, can I just borrow it for a minute?
Huh?
Can I borrow it for a minute?
Oh. Watch it, you don't go over the edge.
Harry, so next time together?
Yeah, all right.
Yeah?
I'll go down, you come up.
So we have tea and biscuits served by the Indian Army at the highest motorable pass in the world.
Yep. Balls, everyone.
Cheers.
It's staggering how many people are up at this height. None of the group are displaying any signs of mountain sickness, but some must be doing better than others, right?
It's a little bit of fun. Now that we're up here, we're all actually feeling pretty fit and well. We're going to measure our O2 sats just to have a little bit of competition to see whose body is doing the best up here. Now, to give you a little idea of what you need to, what your average O2 sats are, they're about what? Usually about 95.
95 is normal.
Yeah,
mine
normal.
Is 98.
Let's see how much Mark gets. Okay.
Now bear in mind,
so Mark, it's your turn.
Mine
please,
was 87,
inside.
And I was poorly. 89. That's not bad.
I'm almost there.
Take your bets, guys. What do you think? What do you think Peter's at?
I think 87, 88.
I can't even get a reading. It's 76! Oh, oh, it's
still alive!
No, no, too much! Too much sausage!
It, right? Oh my god!
Too much.
80, climbing, come on, 81. Okay, I'm predicting Hari will be in the range of maybe 90. No.
No.
No? He's well acclimatized, he should be 80, but still good. Let's see how much he weighs.
84?
Yes.
Hurry. Now just relax. 84.
Yeah,
84.
Baby.
Mohit may have been coping with the altitude, but now he has something else to worry about.
You gotta stay back with your steed, my man.
He has to stay here on the world's highest road. Yeah.
Yeah,
because he lost the key of the car.
Why did you leave the key?
Unfortunately, at 18,300 feet, we happen to lose a key of the Q7. So Audi is going to keep this for display out here.
A lot of mileage.
And because we can't get a flatbed up here to get the car down. And yeah, let's do a strip search. Well, Constance is gonna heart attack because he had to leave one of his Audi Q7s up on the highest motorable road in the world.
It's actually not my car, it's Atwood's car.
Oh!
I really enjoyed being the part of Supercar Club, and this whole trip are really, really memorable moments for my whole life.
It's time to descend. It is at this point, oxygen intoxicated, that the implications of what we've just done begins to dawn on us.
Oh, it was too good, man. Great. I never expected this good, and I've never done it better than this in my lifetime.
All the off-roading was a surprise to me. Starting from the first one to the drifting which we did in Ladakh.
The highlight of the trip, I think, was the drifting.
The trip has been absolutely fantastic. It's been really very well organized. The Supercar Club has done a fantastic job in organizing this.
We've gone through so many valleys and the view is fantastic.
I think the highlight would be when you managed to get one of the wheels of the Q7 up in the air, and we had some sort of strange sounds coming out of the car, and I thought, okay, so this is how it ends for me.
He was lying, he was totally safe the whole time, under
control. Drive over 17,682 feet across the Khardungla Pass.
I think everybody enjoyed it very much. We did quite a lot of drifting, even though we lost quite a few of cars, quite a few Audis.
We had a real funny bunch of episodes over here with Padam and things, but it was a great expedition. The cars were great, the terrain was amazing. It was a good experience overall.
It's been 8 months of hard work where there was an idea to do this trip. And somewhere I said, you know, I want to go to Leh Ladakh and drive. And I'm not a kind of person who says, you know, I want to do things alone. So I said, okay, let's get a bunch of people together.
I always thought that everyone coming from this trip is a little more on the softer side. People haven't driven these cars. Everyone's chauffeur driven to work. How are they going to handle it? But I was absolutely surprised and shocked, taking it as it comes like a regular guy. So that's something which was absolutely fantastic.
And who do you think is the best driver here?
Obviously me, huh?
Ah, me? I think so. I did an excellent job myself.
Of course, me. I mean, come on. Why are you asking me that question? It's not even a doubt.
Well, of course, except for myself.
Moi. I mean, that goes without saying.
An idea of people who have passion for cars and a passion for life, to meet different people and have a good time.
And right after you've heard that statement, you can add my video of flying the Q7.
Live it, only on Togethia TV.